In this video, we are going to understand DVP-14SS PLC trainer. A PLC trainer. This is the PLC trainer we are using. In the further videos, we have to understand how this trainer has been designed. If you have a PLC, you can also design this trainer after viewing this video. Okay? And how to download and upload the videos, how to do simulations, how to monitor. We are going to see everything in this video. So starting with the PLC make, this is Delta PLC 14SS. Now this 14 represent total number of inputs and total number of outputs. So these are the inputs. I can also write it here. These are my inputs. Okay. Now inputs in this PLC are designated by X. Okay. Starting from X0 to X8, these are my inputs. Okay. So let me just put this names as inputs, and these are my outputs similarly. Now outputs are signified by Y0. Okay, it's Y0, Y1, Y2 and up to Y5. These are my outputs, right? So in PLC we have input and outputs, and in this trainer, if you see here, this is the PLC trainer, you can see the inputs and outputs from here. Alright, these are the inputs. Let me let it focus out of focus. Yeah, these are the inputs starting with SS. Now this SS is sync source. I will explain you what is that. And the inputs are X0 to X7. So we have 8 inputs. And here we have a power LED. This is the power LED. This is the run LED. This is the error. So PLC is powered. PLC has been given the power of 24 volts and 0 volt. This is given 24 and 0. This is a DC power supply. This is the earthing. And PLC is right now at run mode. So we'll see that what is the run mode. Otherwise, you can see this slider. This is at run position. So PLC is running. If I slide that to stop, PLC will stop. All right. Oh, excuse me for that. So PLC is at run mode right now. And you can also do that on stop mode. Okay. This is at stop mode. Now this is at run mode. Okay, this is DVP-14SS. So these are the wiring going to the inputs, and these are the wiring, these are going to the outputs. So in outputs we have C0, Y0, C1, Y1, C2, Y2, Y3, Y4 and Y5. So the same has been depicted here. So I'll explain you from this diagram how I have connected the inputs and output to this PLC. In the strainer we have, these are the indicators, 6 indicators, and these are the switches. Now this is a 3-way switch. It goes like this. This is a 1, 2 and 3. So it's a 3-way switch. So we have 2 3-way switches here. So I have took 2 3-way switches here, this one. Okay, then I have an NO switch. These are the NO switches, 2 NO switches and 2 NC switch. So the symbol of NO switch is this one, symbol of NC is this one. Alright, this is the symbol. This is my main emergency. This is to start and stop the PLC. I can power down my PLC from this emergency. I can power it up and power it down. This is the main control of my trainer. Alright, this is a communication cable. Communication cable to program my trainer. So I'll keep the camera here. Now, how to wire the PLC? So initially we have the terminal sync source. Okay, so we have understood what is the sync source in the previous videos. So we have connected 24 volts directly to the sync source of our trainer. Right? So this sync source, I'll show you again, is here, the top terminal. The sync source is given 24 volts directly from the power supply. So you need to have a 24 VDC power supply as well in your trainer. You have to arrange it because this is a DC PLC. Now X0, how X0 is connected? We have took this selector switch, and one end goes to X0 here. Another end goes to X1. So your selector switch, 3-way selector switch, has 4 terminals, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is at below terminal. This is at selector's position 1 right now. Okay, I'll show you how does it work. Then what we have done is, we have took another selector switch and connected in similar way. So one goes to your X2, another goes to X3. Okay, then you have a push button. Push button is connected to X4. Another push button, NO, this is NO, it's connected to X5. This is not 7, this is X5. Then you have 2 NC switches connected to X6 and X7. So one end goes to the PLC input of these input elements. Okay. Now what about the other end? So if you remember the sync source principle, if you're connecting 24 volt to the common or the sync source terminal, you have to connect 0 volt to another end. So another end will be shorted. It is actually shorted in the trainer and is given 0 volt. Like that. That's the only way to connect your inputs, switches to your PLC. There could be another way. You can shift that. You can either connect 0 volt to your sync source and 24 volts, hold on, to the back of your inputs. This will also work. This kind of wiring will also work. Okay, so it's up to you. It's totally up to you how you want to wire your PLC. This both way can be done. So that's how inputs are wired in my trainer, right? In the outputs, what we have done is we have the common. So we have connected 0 volt to our common. Our common is looped with 0 volt. I will loop it like that. Okay, the common is looped with 0 volt. So C0, C1, C1, C2 is given 0 volt, and the output of my trainer is connected to the indicators like that. I hope this makes sense. So we have 6 indicators here. So outputs starting from Y0 to Y5, these are the 6 outputs. So output will get 0 volt from the PLC. These indicators are working on 24 VDC. These are DC indicators. Okay. So one end goes to PLC and another end should be shorted and should be given 24 volts from the power supply. Okay, so we have a power supply, we can short this wire like this. Okay, so 24 volt is coming from the power supply to one end of indicator, and another end goes to the PLC. PLC outputs, these are the outputs. You have to connect switches to the inputs and indicators to the outputs. Then you have RS-485 communication port. This is at the bottom of your PLC. This is to connect the PLC with the HMI. You can connect your HMI via this port and you can communicate and you can monitor and control the inputs and outputs. That's the power supply. So these are the only terminals this Delta 14SS PLC trainer has in our trainer over here. Now let's see how we can monitor these inputs in our software. So the software which you are going to use is WPLsoft. Okay. I can show you the software. This is WPLsoft version 2.36. If you want the software, you can get it from this website. This is available free, of course. This is a freeware software. You can also do simulation in this WPLsoft, right? Now, you have to make sure your PLC is connected. So we have this cable. This is the PLC cable. This is 232 communication port. This is connected to the back of PLC trainer. Alright, so this you must ensure your cable is connected. Once your cable is connected, you have to open the software and you have to link your PLC. In that case, you will go to communication option, communication settings. Okay, in this communication setting, you have to select the type of connection. So our connection is 232, we don't have Ethernet, it's 232. Then you have to select your COM port. A COM port is very important. If you are connecting this PLC to a desktop, then you will have COM1 here. Okay, although I'm using a desktop, but my COM port is damaged, so I'm using USB to serial converter. In that case, my COM port is COM7. I can show you that. You go to control panel and then you go to device manager, which must be here. That's device manager. Then you check your ports. So in my case, I'm using a USB to serial converter and which is linked with COM7. That's the COM7, right? If you're using USB to serial, you must install its driver, then it will give you a COM. So in our case, it's COM7. Rest will be default. Okay, it will take default. And then you have to click auto detect and let your software find the PLC. So it finds the PLC, which says it is SS because we are using SSCDs. These are the protocols. 9600 is a baud rate, 7 is a data length, even is a parity, 1 is a stop bit. COM port 7, mode is sky. So we have ensured the PLC is connected. Okay, so I'm going to make a dummy program and download that to PLC. In fact, I'll just write the blank program. I'll just write the end because we are just going to monitor it. So to download the program, there are several steps. One is, first we will compile it. So to compile the logic, I can just extend it a little. Thus you can see that code. Click on that, it will compile. And it says I have used just one step out of 3792 steps. This PLC supports 3792 total steps of programming. So I have used just one step, which is the end. Alright. Now I'll download that to PLC. This is the option, write to PLC. Click on that and then click OK. Click yes and yes. So the dummy program, which is like it's nothing, only the blank program is downloaded. Now I'll go to online mode, because we are just doing monitoring, we are not programming it. Then you go to edit monitor devices. Alright, now here we want to see how our inputs are connected. So starting with X0, I'll write here, I'll just type X0 and press enter. X1, enter. X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, X7. So we have 8 inputs. Now you see here, X0, this is the status, current status of my PLC. Right now X0 is off. So if I turn on X0, it will show X0 is on in the software. I can move it like this. Okay, X0 is on. Next is X1. So this says X1 is on. Then we have X2. This is X2. This is X3. And then we have X4. This is X5. Now this is because it's NC, that's why its status is already high. It is passing the signal. It is making the circuit. So if I press this button, it will show X6 is off. And this is for X7. So these are the inputs, how we can link the inputs, how PLC detects the inputs. If you do the correct wiring, you will see the status. If you're not seeing the status, it means there's some problem in your wiring. Now let's see the output. Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4 and Y5. Alright, now output I can directly turn on from my software. Hold on. These are my outputs. What I can actually do is, I can do set on. And you can see which output is getting on. So this is your Y0. Okay. This is Y1. This is Y2. Y3. That's Y4. And that's Y5. Alright, so this is these are the outputs. You can also turn it on, all of them. It's up to you. Okay, so this was how you can turn off the output, turn on and off the output, and you can monitor which output is connected to which terminal. Okay, so next is we'll see how to download and upload the program. A small demo of downloading and uploading the program in Delta WPL. So let me extend the line. I'll go back to my ladder mode. This was the monitoring mode from here. You click on the ladder diagram, you'll go to the ladder diagram. So when you want to download the program, you have to make sure your PLC is not online. This is online, PLC is running. Offline the PLC. Now I need a space between the end, so I'll press Ctrl I. Now let's write a simple program to turn on the output using one input. So I'll write LDX0. LDX0 is my NO contact of X0 switch here. Okay, I'll just okay. Then I have to write OUT space Y0. OUT space Y0 is out Y0. This will turn on my Y0, which is this one. Now to download the program, same steps. You have to follow the same steps. First, code the program, compile, write to PLC, press OK and yes again. Then click online. Now program has been written and this is online, so if I turn on my X0, it will turn on my Y0. So this is simultaneously monitoring the status. I hope this makes sense. Now this was how to download the program. Suppose in case you are working on your program and you lost the program, you don't know what was the program inside it. So what you can do is you can upload the program from the PLC. You can transfer the logic from PLC to your software. In that case, you have to click on this button, read from PLC. Once you click on this button, you'll find the communication mode PLC to PC. Click OK, yes and OK. So you will get your program right in your software. And then if you want to save your program, whatever you're doing here, go to File, Save As, and then you have to go to your desktop, save the program, Project 1, click Save. So if you save it and if you close it thereafter, you can again open the software, it will save it by the extension DVP. So you can again open the last program which you have saved, just like you work on Microsoft Word and all. So click File and click Open. Project 1 must be in the desktop. This one. So that's your program. So this is how you can save, you can close, and you can open your program. So this was about how to work with PLC, how to download and upload the program. Now let's take a situation when you don't have the PLC. Okay, if you are a student and if you can't afford the PLC, you can work on simulations. To do that, let me just turn off my PLC. I'll turn off my PLC. So now there is no PLC. Okay, my software doesn't recognize any PLC. Or if you want, I can remove this communication cable just to make sure that my PLC is not connected. In that case, what we have to do is you have to click on this symbol, simulator. Click this one. It will show you simulator, and if you get some message like that, give them some access, allow the access. Okay, you must notice this should be simulator, right? Now the software will act like you have the real PLC with you. So if this is my logic, I have to code it first, compile, write to PLC, click OK. And then you go online. Okay, sometime you may find the timeout error. Alright, now in case if you found the timeout error, like the one you have seen right now, what you have to do is, because many times you will encounter some issues like timeout, close your program, then go to WPL, right click on that, go to properties, and in compatibility, click on run this program in compatibility mode for Windows XP, and click select this run this program as an administrator. This is mandatory. Click apply, click close. Then open the same logic which you saved. It will ask you for the confirmation, and when you start it, this time it may not ask you or it may not show you the timeout error. So let's check that. So this time go to simulator. I have a simulator here. Compile, download, click OK. It has downloaded now. Click on online. So you get the online, it says it's stop. Run the PLC from here. Now how to turn on the X0? You don't have the inputs. So right click, set on. The output is on. Right click, set off. So now you can work by right clicking the input and doing it set on and on, set off, to check your logics. So this is how you can work on simulations in Delta WPL Soft software. And if you want to download this software, go to help or go to this website delta.com.tv, and you can find the software in the download section. So this is about introduction to PLC trainer of Delta DVP 14SS. If you have any doubt, you can pop me a comment. Thank you so much.